Hi there, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che.
And I'm Ben Peltier. Later in this week's show, pianist and composer Anson Wong will be joining us to talk about his upcoming performance in the Hong Kong Children's Symphony Orchestra's annual concert this Sunday.
But first, the art of words, and we're introducing an ongoing exhibition at the Hong Kong Museum of Art that highlights the structure and shape of Chinese characters throughout their long history and the ways in which they are sometimes adapted creatively in the modern world.
虽然汉字和书法对于中国的观众来说不陌生的，但是这个展览是很难得地将不同的收藏，例如它有民间的文字的游戏，文人怎样在玩诗词，甚至我们的二十四节气怎样可以通过汉字的组合去玩一些对联，这些都是很难得地一次过在香港展览中展示给大家。
By the People, Creative Chinese Characters is the second exhibition in the Hong Kong Museum of Art's Hong Kong Art Co-Creation Series. This one is co-curated by local designer Freeman Lau, whose work regularly incorporates traditional Chinese elements. He has been interested in the creativity of Chinese characters and calligraphy for many years. The exhibition features more than 100 exhibits in various media, collected by Lau as well as by other artists, private collectors, and institutions. It highlights the relationship between Chinese characters, calligraphy, everyday life, and contemporary art.
最奇异呢，即系汉字系由人去产生嘅。咁我亦都讲紧咧，就系话咧，即系相对于书法咧，由书法家去做，但系汉字咧就由人去做出嚟嘅。咁即系讲紧咧，我哋呢个包含咧就系更加阔，系一啲平民、民间嘅智慧都包含喺里边嘅。The
exhibition opens with the development of Hong Kong's own Chinese characters. In 1843, Yinghua College, founded by the missionary Robert Morrison, moved to the territory from Malacca. The school set up a printing press on its own premises to publish the Chinese Bible and other Chinese Christian tracts and publications. The typeface used is called Hong Kong type. It's the most complete set of lead cast movable Chinese type from the 19th century.
跟住咧就已經有一套屬於自己嘅字體咧，咁呢個全世界嘅城市都冇一個咁嘅古仔啦，好有趣。即係除咗香港體之外，亦都有九龍體嘅喎。其實就係由日本嘅設計師咧，因為佢哋好中意香港文化嘅，咁佢哋喺九十年代初嗰陣時候咧，就做咗一套叫做九龍體嘅字體嘅示範。
In the 1960s and 1970s, as the Hong Kong economy rapidly expanded, Chinese calligraphy increasingly became part of everyday life, especially in the business sector, often in the form of handwritten name cards.
七八十年代就喺街頭裏邊去寫卡片嘅書法家做出嚟嘅一啲卡片啦，即係你可以想象中嗰陣時候大家互相交換卡片嗰陣時候咧，其實係交換緊一個書法作品嘅。
The exhibition also has three passageways that highlight the creative use of Chinese characters in a cultural life. One area focuses on the work for Hong Kong movies of Feng Xiuhua or Hua Guo, who created the calligraphy for the titles of over 50 popular Hong Kong movies.
呢一個咧，我哋係利用咗絕大部分係華哥先生嘅書法字咧，就拼成咗一個壁畫咁嘅形式咧，等到啲公眾人士咧係喺兩個展廳裏邊咧係穿過嗰陣時候咧，都有另外一個感受咯。好少地方一個城市咧係咁大量嘅香港嘅片咧嘅電影製作咧係由一個書法家去寫嘅，而華哥先生咧咁佢都係寫咗好多唔同嘅風格。 咁佢就好似嗰啲即係黑社會題材嘅電影咧，咁佢都係寫咗嗰種即係江湖味出嚟嘅，咁好難得。咁當然啦，亦都有一啲佢比較文化啲嘅。
The omnipresent King of Kowloon, a large mural by another mountain man, mirrors an installation by Professor Chan Yuk Kung. Both pay tribute to Mr. Zhang Zhou Choi, the King of Kowloon. For the final section of the exhibition, artists and designers from Hong Kong and elsewhere in Asia were asked to integrate Chinese characters and calligraphy into contemporary art forms.
这一位是一个日本的女书法家川美鹏子小姐其实她的书法是在地上高是写一个两米乘两米那么大的书法字她是跟一个摄影家合作将她写书法的时候的动作用光影地记录下来因为你的整个人去运动而是写出一个大字那个韵律呢 其實都好像舞蹈那麼漂亮的用這個方法去另外一個方面去看一個書法的美另外當然也有近代強先生就請了UCO-NAP一個年輕的團隊將他這個書法和山水結合的境界變為一個電子版本由一個靜態一路慢慢見到他真的是一個山林的感覺
If you're curious about what the inside of at least one artist's mind might look like, you can dive into the psychological landscape of Korean artist JeeYoung Lee at La Galerie. The idea of self-reflection, identity, and human existence inspired Lee to create her photography series, Stage of Mind. The works combine painting, installation, sculpture, mixed media, and performance.
Lee spends weeks or even months in his studio to stage and build theatrical sets that represent her emotional experiences. She then records these inner landscapes with a large format 4x5 film camera. Once captured, the sets are demolished, a process that she says allows her to observe herself from creation to destruction.
I practice Cook의 영화, 새와 그리고 그리스 신화 판도라의 박스에서 영감을 받은 작품이고요. 그 다음에 이제 검은 새 같은 경우는 제가 삶에서 느꼈던 많은 어려움이나 이제 역경들을 표현하고 있어요. 그래서 이제 이 작업에서 보시면은 새들은 조금 부정적인 요소들을 대표한다고 보시면 될 것 같고 하지만 그와 반대되는 의미로 이제 역시 희망을 나타내는 문과 열쇠들이 있어요. 그래서 창문 같은 경우는 이제 우리가 뭐 새로운 세상, 또 새로운 출구 또는 새로운 길 같은 것을 의미할 수 있는 장치고요.
Welcome back. Many composers and musicians began their musical journey at early ages. Hong Kong-born Anson Wong was just four when he began studying music. A graduate of the Diocesan Boys' School, he also began studying at the Hong Kong Academy for Performing Arts since he was nine, majoring in piano, bassoon, and composition. Anson's a former bassoon player with the Hong Kong Children's Symphony Orchestra. He'll be joining them in Tsuen Wan Town Hall this Sunday for the annual concert, but this time at the piano. He's with us right now to tell us more.
Well, Anson, it's a delight to have you here in the studio. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for inviting.
Yeah, so I'd like to jump right in to this very interesting concert that you're doing with the Hong Kong Children's Symphony Orchestra that you used to play bassoon in, which is just a remarkable sort of full circle event that you're coming back as the piano soloist with them on this coming Sunday. What piece are you going to do with them?
I'm going to play Beethoven's fifth piano concerto, also called the Emperor Concerto.
The Emperor Concerto of Beethoven. It truly is one of the milestone pieces, or one of the best known of all the piano concertos. And there certainly are so many great piano concertos, and this is one of the very, very best.
Yes.
And so it must be quite a special piece to tackle as a soloist.
So I first started learning the concerto when I was 16 or 15. At that time, I only learned the first movement, but I already liked the piece very much, especially the second and the third movements. The second movement for me is very special because I think that B major in E flat major is a very special key. And the way he creates the imagery is very magical and exquisite, yeah.
What is it about those keys that sort of brings something to life for you?
I think the outer movements are in a very different mood and style contrast with the second movement. As you know, the first and the third movement is quite militaristic in nature, I can say. And the second movement is very poetic and calm and beautiful. And a bit like a nocturne in some ways, especially the orchestra part is very, very beautiful. So this has always been a very favorite concerto of mine. Yeah.
And then what's the experience like, or sort of this sort of odd sense that you're coming back to this ensemble that you used to play in?
I'm very happy to come back to the Hong Kong Children's Symphony Orchestra because it has been such happy moments in my life playing in that orchestra. So I joined the orchestra in 2011, and I played in the orchestra for 2 years. And I've gone with tours with them to Australia and New Zealand with the bassoon. So I made a lot of friends in the orchestra. So very happy to be back.
It's really quite an unusual thing for someone to, as another instrumentalist, sort of an orchestral instrumentalist, to then come back on a different instrument and solo with the same orchestra. Kind of a fun moment, I'm sure, for all yes. parties involved. I'd like to actually also talk about another area of your musical endeavors, which is your compositional side of things. And you've been doing that for quite a number of years, haven't you, the
yes.
composition stuff. What sort of drew you to that aspect of music as well as performing?
So I started learning basic composition in some Yamaha Junior music courses. So at that time, there are some training in composition, and every year students would present their own original pieces in the junior original composition concert. So this motivated me as a kid to learn composition. But at first, of course, teachers help a lot in the process. And after some years, we start composing on our own. And after I entered APA, which is the Hong Kong Academy for Performing Arts, I enrolled in the composition department of the junior APA, and I start composing in more contemporary styles, which is very new to me. Yeah.
And so you're just at the beginning of your musical journey. You're in fact still just finishing up things at the Academy for Performing Arts, I understand.
Yes.
And yet you have quite an accumulated track record of different activities musically that you've done, and we haven't even touched on much of your piano playing yet in our conversation, which has in your past dealt with, you've had success at some competition aspects of being a pianist. And then I think More lately, you're developing in other areas as a chamber musician and some other things. So where do you see yourself going in the future? And perhaps if folks are interested in what they learn about you here in this show, how can they come to, say, an upcoming concert beyond this coming Sunday? What's coming up for you?
So I have a concert after the Sunday concert on 26th of May. It's a concert with the Hong Kong Generation Next Arts with Licky and Timothy Choi. So I will be playing some pieces that are written for piano and two violins.
Is it especially fun for you to play chamber music, which is sort of in the middle ground between solo piano and as a concerto soloist?
Actually, it's a very favorite genre of music for me. I've played many different chamber music works. For example, the Franck Violin Sonata. And I've played with, as you have said before, Dina and Anders from the Hong Kong field in the previous HKGNA concert. So yes, I like chamber music very much, and I enjoy playing chamber music.
So what's next for you after, you know, beyond the APA and beyond these next couple of concerts that you've just highlighted for us? Where would you like to go, as career-wise as a pianist? Where do you see yourself?
So next year I'll be going to the UK to study at the Royal Academy of Music. And I think after the master's, I'll be probably doing doctorate. So of course, I wish to perform on a high level in the future around the world. And also, I hope to teach some more in different parts of the world.
Thank you again for coming in, and really excited to hear you play something for us here in the studio. What piece would you like to play for us?
So today I've brought the Rachmaninoff Prelude Opus 23, number 2. So as you know, this year is the 150th anniversary of Rachmaninoff's birth. So actually, April 1st is his birthday. Yes, so today is a very special day for me to bring some Rachmaninoff music here.
Yeah. Very timely and very appropriate.
Yeah.
Anson, thanks so much for coming in. I'm excited to hear you play it.
Thank you.